this special episode of Matt's Rad Show. Usually filming classic cars, today I'm filming a classic battleship, the last of its kind. The USS Salem. Built between 1945 and 1947, it was finally commissioned in 1949 and served as one of the Navy's most powerful vessels of its time. Though the ship hasn't seen any combat, it has had its fair share of misfortune. And it's said that many of the crew still walk the corridors, decks, and rooms of the ship. Many of the volunteers that work the ship will tell you, it's haunted. At least six sailors died on the ship while being treated for wounds that they received from an explosion happening on a different ship. Many people have experienced objects moving on their own. They've seen apparitions of men walking the hallways. They've heard unexplained voices. Some of those even calling people by name. And I can attest, you really do feel like you're being watched when walking around the ship. The reason it might be so haunted, though, might not be just because of the sailors who died on the ship. In August of 1953, there was a massive earthquake in Greece. With the nearby Ionian Island region suffering from lack of hospitals, many Navy ships came to help. The ship was said to have helped over 1,000 people from those earthquakes, but unfortunately, many of them died on the ship. There's no record as to how many, but estimates say it could be as much as 100. The ship has been deemed by the Travel Channel as one of America's most terrifying places. It's also considered one of the most haunted ships in the world. Now, I'm no ghost hunter, but I do love exploring so-called haunted places. And call me crazy, but I like to do it alone. So come with me today as we explore this entire ship, one of America's last historic battleships. It was genuinely a haunting experience, as you'll see. Thanks for watching this special episode of Matt's Rad Show. The USS Salem, otherwise known as the Sea Witch. Look at this, this is incredible. Look at the size of these guns. I have to go in there, I think, next. Yeah, we'll go down there next. Oh, look at this. Oh my gosh, dude, look at that.
These are massive guns. I've heard, my grandpa was on a destroyer in World War II, and I've heard stories that if you were on the deck near these guns when they went off, they would suck you right off the ship. You don't want to be anywhere near these things when they go off. That's what I've heard anyway. Someone can confirm if that's true or not. I imagine you definitely don't want to be near them when they're going off. My gosh, this thing is... Wow. Restricted area. This is the bathroom, it looks like. The deck's all old and like rotted and like... Clean the lens off here for you guys again. Just kind of want to walk around the outside of the ship first and then we'll get inside. Make my way around here. The floor kind of tricked me out there. Man, this is awesome. Now we'll try to find a spot to head into the ship here. See if this goes well. Okay. All right. Here we go. extra squeaky. I apologize for the extra squeakiness. It was wet outside, so. This is incredible. Waste fresh water. Pour your fresh water down in here. Gotta hang on to all that fresh water. Look at this. Do we go deeper? Let's go deeper. Grandpa had this knife that he had on his wall in his basement in his rec room, and he said he used that knife for everything. Like, they issued it to him in the Navy, and he said he just used that knife to basically eat everything. It was interesting, the stories of that knife. I don't know what kind of knife it was, or if it was standard issue kind of thing. I think it was. Grandpa was on the USS Plunkett in World War II. That was a destroyer. This is, of course, a battleship. That's where we just were. So we're going around in circles here. You can get turned around in here. It's really... I want to go down further here. That says exit. Look at this, where they slept. Man, just think about being a young guy or girl and being away from your family, maybe for the first time ever. You get your assignment to the ship and pull your stuff up and here you are. Night night, sleep tight. That's where that saying comes from, when the beds were pulled tight like that. It's insane. It looks like they fold up too to make more room. Or maybe just that one does to get down there, I don't know. It looks like they all might do it. Here's a mirror. Gdunk. What's a gdunk? At the gdunk. Some lockers here. This is fascinating. I think this is, let's go back where we just were. Look this way here. Look at that. All the ventilation shafts everywhere and the plumbing and the inner workings of the ship. Just imagine walking around in here like during, you know, some pretty fair seas when the ocean chopped up a bit. Man, more bunks and everything. Try going up these stairs over here. This is a museum, so I suppose these are museum pieces here. Refreshments before the movie starts. They got a projector right there. A newer one, of course. I'm wondering if they didn't have a projector in here somewhere. An old film projector. If that's what they use this room for, I don't know. I'm guessing they had no hometown ghost stories. this. Cash only and get done.
Look at these guys, man. A different generation, man. Nothing but respect for them. My grandpa was a different kind of guy. He could just, he didn't like to talk about it that much, but he did. I had a school assignment one time when I was in school, and I got to call him and ask him questions about it for a school project when I was in elementary school, and listening to just all over the world, like it went, and just, it was really fascinating. That was somebody walking around upstairs just now. A little museum room here. Got some information up about history of it and everything. History. That's cool. Wow, look at this. This is awesome. All these different models of all these ships. USS Missouri. Look at that. Fighting or something. Looks like a holding cell, doesn't it? And brig. Oh yeah, send him down to the brig. Look at that, oh my gosh. People are walking around upstairs, I think. At least I hope they are. Navy SEALs. Here just reading all this stuff. Fortunately, I don't have that time, but cruise back here. See if we can find a way. Oh, here we down there. Auxiliary room, no public entry, staff only. Electric shop. Officer's wardroom. Saw a sign for that. That's not what this room is, I don't think. Maybe, I don't know. I don't know if that's just telling you that's what this room is. Officer's wardroom. If we can get back there. I'm not sure. I think I passed up the, oh wow, look at the bullets. Those are, this looks like wood. So just a example of how big they were. Oh, dentist. Suppose you're on a ship. It's a small village. Not even small, it's a village. You gotta have everything on the ship that you would normally have, that you need. Engineer officer. My grandpa was a machinist, so he was down in the machine rooms, working on all the engines and stuff. And they have doors on the, you know, to the outside of the ship at some point. And he remembers watching a torpedo miss the ship that he was on. He said he saw it go by in the water. I can't imagine what that was like while he was looking out of one of those doors. Second division here. What's going on? There's definitely a different feel to this area of the ship. Areas depending on your rank that you're just maybe not allowed to be in. I don't know. I would guess that's how it works. That's a good movie. I've seen that movie. Okay. Here's another spot to go back up. Let's see where we're at. Just one. Look at that. All right, we're back in the front of the ship here. We kind of started up here, and then we walked to the back, and we went down under. And we walked the length of the ship back to the front. Start walking around, but the tour entrance is right here, I guess. Oh no, my shoes are all squeaky again. Other doors on this level I want to kind of walk into here. They've got a video playing. Further up, Chief of Staff. I'm gonna keep going up here. So we're gonna... We'll keep going up. Let's explore this floor, fourth division. Division's officer. I think those are all. Yeah, those are all locked. Look at that. get a little bit higher on the ship here now. Looks like they allow you to... Oh, here we go. That was cool. That's cool that they let you do that. Gosh, look at this. Paint is all chipping. Oh my God. Look at that. We are steering the ship. Oh my gosh, dude. Yellow. That's insane. Yellow stuff down to, I don't know, maybe the engine room. Look at this. It's amazing. You think, oh man, why do they have bigger windows? They could see better. It's like, well, so they don't get shot? Ah, restricted area. As high as we go for now. What's up there? I don't know what's up there. Look at this. All the operations and stuff. Pilot house, look at that. back outside here. That was the pilot house. That was really cool. I wasn't sure if we were going to be able to get in there or not and see that. So that's really cool. I think that's maybe the way we... making sure there's no other ways we can get any higher up. I think that's about as high as they allow you to go, it appears. Because yeah, that's the way we cruised on over here. But that's, we're pretty much yeah, that's the pilot house there. Yeah, not much higher you can go. I mean, you can a little bit, looks like. It doesn't appear that we can go any higher than this, though. Man, this has been fascinating, honestly. Look at that. Imagine standing right here when you launch them big guns. Some radar there. Look at that, the old, I guess it's just part of the old table. I thought it was an old map or something, but it's all crusted up and cracked like old mud. Ship count, pilot house, flag, shared flag plot, signal officer's house, combat info center, calling the different ship rooms and stuff, get information or to give information, I suppose. I guess that's what you call people, right? This has really been cool to walk around in, man. One of the first battleships I've ever been able to like walk around and check out. We walked through here, I think, right? Again, it's discombobulating here. Trying to figure out. I guess we gotta go down this way to get out. We'll just film stuff as we're working our way out of the ship here. We walk around all this stuff. This is the Admiral's thing here. I honestly can't remember if I've been through this part or not. Yeah, okay. Can we check that spot out? Let's cruise down this way. Deep stairs. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at this. I don't know if we could made it out here. Oh yeah, we did. I rang the bell right here. Yeah. Let's look over here. Oh, look at that. Lifeboat. It's amazing. Look at that. And it's so cool that they haven't scrapped this, because that's what happened to a lot of them, the old ones. Decommissioned and scrapped. That's what happened to the destroyer that my grandpa worked on. Got scrapped. Got all the lettering on here. Start making our way back down here. Lifeboats this ship had and where they put them all. Look at that. All right. What is that noise? Oh, this thing is making noise. It's like ticking. But yeah, we've been in this area here before. All right. Alrighty, gang. Well, I think that's about going to wrap up this episode. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it. Definitely come check out this ship if you get a chance. It's pretty amazing. I gotta admit, I'm a bit lost right now and I can't seem to find my way out. We'll figure it out. I'm not worried. Definitely been around here before. I'll go back around this way. Went through this way before. Yeah. Crazy. I literally going in circles now. I feel like the ship is messing with me. there's that again. I'm just trying to get back out. I wasn't paying attention as I'm walking through everything. Just filming stuff. So I just went down there and now I'm back here, around here. And I walked through here. I was trying to follow exit signs and it brought me out of the ship. Okay, I'm back here. Yeah, I remember walking past through here. They're playing music and stuff over here, so. Oh, it's like the captain's room. USS Salem. Ship movie, I'm guessing, was filmed right here. All right, I really got to try to figure out how to get out of here, though. I might as well just keep filming until I get out of here. I think I'm going to have to go back down. See, I went up there. Okay, we looked in there. I must be on the main deck now again. Okay. Alrighty. Okay, now, yeah. Here we are. I know where I'm at now. I think I can just walk around to the other side and I'll be good to go. Sun's starting to come out. I felt like the ship was messing with me for a minute there. Like, I just kept getting turned around. I kept thinking I was walking out of the ship, going the right direction, but I kept circling back around to where I was just at. Ship's messing with me. Yeah. Sun's starting to come out here. Look at that. Hang on a second. Here we are. Look at that. All right. Now we'll walk. Sun's starting to come out. Rain stopped. Look at this. Oh man, my feet are soggy now. The ship is taking on water. It's crazy that there's a wooden decking on this ship. I didn't realize they had wooden decking at one point, but I suppose why not? Yeah, look at that. Sun came out. Just filming some shots of the ship in the sun here until my battery dies on me. In here. This is one a little tricky to get in. Wow. Look at that. How they loaded it and everything. I was talking to one of the guys on the ship, one of the volunteers. He was saying these guns were radar guided, anti-aircraft guns. So he said they would rarely miss. Your position. Can't imagine. Turret 2. Look at that. Some big ammunition. All right, gang, my battery's starting to die here. So I'm gonna need to say goodbye and say thank you for watching. I appreciate it. And I will hopefully get off this ship at some point. I think if I keep walking this way, I'll get off. But if this video has been uploaded, it means that I got off the ship. At some point, if you don't actually see the ending of it here. Well, now, okay, I need to go take a look. I think I can maybe need to go down a floor to get off the ship. Oh no, here we go. Aha, here we are, folks. We made it. USS Salem. Alrighty. Thanks for watching, everybody. Until next time. Check you later.